how you move a poem from the page into the visual space, give it texture and that sound, and that emotion. It excites me. Hi, I'm Julianknxx. I'm a visual artist and a poet. I've got a show at the Barbican Curve. I don't think I decided I want to become an artist. I don't think it was like, yeah, today. It's the day. But what I did do is quit my job to figure out why I'm here. I had to figure out to be an artist without thinking about space. Space in London is a luxury, right? So if you wait to have a space for you to make work, it'll just, yeah, it would never happen. So I had to think about a way of building a practice that space becomes secondary. I do these sketches, and they started off as like anxiety drawings. The human mind always kind of look for a face in any shape, just to kind of concentrate my mind. They then appear in different ways and different places in my work. This book is called Big Drum Ritual from Karaku. The subtext is praise songs in memory of flight, and I change it to chorus in memory of flight. So I borrowed her title. I was really moved by how her going to Karaku and just going through all the rituals, like tracing all the big drum patterns. And it's just interesting to see how these traces of like global history always find Sierra Leone in them. Often the story of blackness just stays in the Americas. And I wanted to think about how you draw those lines across Europe, across, you know, the Americas, across Africa. This, with this character looking across into the square mile, into the city of London. And this is the opening scene. So just thinking about like this idea of the departure. So I went to 7 European countries, port cities, so water's a way into each city. And then once we were in, it's then thinking about music and the different ways in which we use music to gather, to come around and share space, hold space, and carry each other. The final part was asking people to give an offering that sort of sits with what they feel the city is to them, allowing people to speak up. I didn't go into the work thinking about how it's gonna finish. So I was finding out about what we're making as I was going along. I had written some poems at the beginning, but then after the encounters, it was just kind of like me responding to the conversations. One of the conversations I had in Barcelona, did you know that during the slave trade, sharks changed their route because there was a bloodier route for them to swim through? When you think about much of this work and much of the reason why the world is the way it is right now, it's because of greedy sharks.